In a lot of the exploration and conservation efforts that I was involved in, it was always clear that there were a lot of really human-intensive tasks that could be optimized by AI or other technology. As an example, in ocean exploration, it's popular to put down cameras for 12 hours or more and put down lots of cameras to record the marine species. You bring up 10 cameras that all have 12 hours of footage on it, and you're all living on a ship at the time, and you now have to watch through that 12 hours of footage. And that sounds easy, right? It sounds like binging Netflix, but it's just not. You know, you're stopping at every frame to draw a box around something or look to see what it is. And the reality is a lot of data that's collected for scientific purposes does not get looked at because of that human labor effort. We had 3D scanned a Sumatran rhino, and this is a pretty crazy, incredible project. There's only about 80 Sumatran rhinos left in the world. We built a wall of cameras so that when the Sumatran rhino would walk in front of them, it would capture with all these cameras at once, and we could build a 3D reconstruction of this rhino. And so I took this 3D model that our big camera array built, and I actually used it to train an AI. To my surprise, it actually trained the AI really well. It was as if I went out and grabbed thousands and thousands of images of Sumatran rhinos. I got an AI that worked that good just off of this one model.
Our product is RAKE, and it stands for Rapid Automatic Image Categorization. Is that technology that allows you to take that one source image of anything, any image of anything you're looking for, and search your entire data set for like items in RAKE space.
So you come with just this massive amount of unlabeled data in a particular domain, and you can basically feed all of this data that you might not know much about through our system, and our RAKE system provides its own interpretation of that data for you, giving you this interface into your data that you otherwise wouldn't have.
When the idea came to me for Synthetaic, I just had the idea of there's got to be a better way to build AI without labeling data. And we've built an AI tool set that can actually use AI to label the data, as opposed to humans labeling it, is where the evolution has gone over time.
We've built this human AI interface where the back end of our product is this unsupervised AI that builds its own representation of your data. And then you work with that AI to build a more specific and purposeful AI for a task that you want to carry out.
Because our product actually maps imagery into what we call RAKE space and can train an AI much more quickly and more efficiently, we can actually train an AI model in about 30 seconds.
Our AI is based on Azure and the capabilities within Azure. Microsoft Azure product is a backbone of Synthetaic's technology. And I know they've been an incredible partner in that business strategy aspect as well.
We use the virtual machines to run most of our core product on, but we also use the Azure storage. We use the Azure service bus to integrate all of the workflow between all of the different parts that we have going on, Azure Kubernetes services. And for us, you know, one of the real keys to that is that having everything on the same cloud platform running basically right next to each other lets us run things very, very fast. And since we're building a product that says you don't need to label data and you can build that first AI in 30 or 40 seconds, really latency matters a lot at that point in the game. So being able to run everything on Azure with the interconnectivity has been awesome. Basically for our customers, it's all about getting to that first AI quickly and at low enough budget that it makes sense to take chances and do experimentation. I think one of the things that is sort of lost in AI because of the 6-month labeling timeline that you might take and then days and days of AI training that you often do is this feeling of rapid experimentation. And AI is still more art than it is science. You still need to iterate, you still need to try things and make a bunch of mistakes. And Synthetaic lets our customers make those mistakes much more cheaply, and so they can get the right answer that they're looking for business value.